Welcome to the Utopia Coliseum, home to our series today. Welcome to Minor League Esports. I am your host, Fallen, and today we're going to be bringing you four series over here on the B stream and four over on the main stream in an hour. Beginning, firstly, however, with a wonderful series here between the Rhinos and the Outlaws in the Champion League. But before we get into that, let me introduce to you my wonderful co-caster for this evening. It is Mr. Tourney Ernie.
Thank you, Fallen. I appreciate the introduction. I cannot wait to get this matchup underway between the Rhinos and the Outlaws, as it's still early on in the season and we got to get through those divisional matchups, and this one should be a close one.
Yeah, we do have a very strong lineup from both sides of the field today. The Rhinos pulling out all the stops with Mayhem and Rualiel. I believe I'm pronouncing that correctly. He will kill me afterwards if I didn't. Meanwhile, on the Outlaws, we have Luke and the Evilers back playing. Two very strong players. You know a little bit about how the Outlaws have been playing, though, this season. I feel like they've been playing strong so far. Tell us a little bit about it.
So for the Outlaws, you mentioned, I think, just before the stream started, the Outlaws 5-0'd a very, very good Bears team. And as for the Rhinos, they're 0-2 to start the season, I believe. Yes, they're 0-2 to start the season, and they've yet to win a series, but they've just been ever so close each time.
Yeah, both series almost coming down to a game between them losing, I believe it was, to the Shadow and Pirates teams. But two very strong, very stacked lineups in that process. And now looking to try and change it up with a lineup we haven't seen before in the two players today. Honestly, I feel like this could be their chance to really get a lot of games on the board here and take this take some of that backwards momentum that they've been suffering and turn it into forward momentum and push themselves up those rankings.
Mm-hmm. As it looks like everyone's in the lobby, I'm waiting to see if we're all good to go.
Should be any second now. All right, and as we get everyone onto the field, it's going to be an interesting game. What is your prediction for who takes this one?
For me, part of me wants to give the Outlaws the edge, maybe 3-2, a 4-1 victory for the Outlaws.
I'm thinking mainly because I know Evil and I know he'll have a go at me for how biased his commentary is going to be at times. I'm going to say that the Rhinos are going to take this one 3-2 and get their first series win of the season. As the kickoff does go in favor of the Outlaws, they'll send it deep into the Rhinos' half, but Mayhem will take control of it. Looks to drive it towards the midfield, but Luke will cut it off and dump in front of the pass. Almost gets a shot on target. It will sit in front of the net. Opportunity again for Evil, but a great save from Rualiel. We'll keep the score at 0-0 here. Mayhem now looks to bring it out of his own half. Lays it across the field, looking for maybe a pass, but instead just waits on the side wall, allows Evil to get the clear away, and the Outlaws look to take control here in this series. Another good save from Mayhem this time to keep the Outlaws at bay, and 50 seconds in, and it feels like the Rhinos are already sitting back a little bit and allowing the Outlaws to apply pressure.
Yeah, the Outlaws are applying a lot of offensive pressure, but the Rhinos seem to really be looking for those quick transition counterattacks. Evil, the bounce shot isn't going to go through, but for the Rhinos, we'd like to see them push forward a little more.
Yeah, as this one comes towards the net, Mayhem will get the clear out into the midfield. I like that little play there from Luke, coming in front of the player, try and act as a blocker in a sense, so Evil can get a better challenge. Has worked out for the moment, as the Rhinos again are forced to clear from their own backboard and corner, and now, maybe with an opportunity to come forward, but a great beat from Luke will tee him up. Rualiel's being bumped on the goal line, but will still get the save and the clear away, and now the Rhinos looking for a counterattack.
Rhinos off the backboard. The Outlaws have done a great job so far of denying those bounces off the backboard out and back into the midfield.
Oh, that might have been a mistake though there from Mayhem, and it will allow Luke to get the first goal of this series. A great little controlling touch here before taking it across the line. The Outlaws lead 1-0.
Yeah, Mayhem just got a little too much on that bounce off the wall, put it right back into the middle. And Rua was upfield and allowed Luke to score on that open net.
now the Outlaws look to control it, send it deep into the Rhino's half there from Evil. Now looking to pinch it into the middle, he'll do so. Mayhem will bait out the challenge. No, he won't. He'll just wait it out instead. And the Rhinos will survive another attack as the Outlaws are forced to backpedal into their own half here. And the first real chances come out from
what
the Rhinos.
Shot.
And they will find the back of the net. Ruwaliel opens his scoring for the season.
Rua's going to come from the opposite direction, goes and just tucks it inside the post. Phenomenal shot, and the Rhinos claw their way back into it.
Absolutely brilliant shot there from Ruwaliel, and it sort of came out of nowhere. It felt like it's just been Outlaws' offensive pressure, and now they get another opportunity here. The ball will just dangle delicately in front of the net, but there won't be a shot from it. And now the Outlaws, with a little bit more control, with the ball in front of the box, will go for another passing play across. It just will not connect again. And it feels like there is a little bit of a breakdown there between the Outlaws in that position. They don't necessarily seem to be hooking up perfectly on offense so far, but you know that that's only going to improve as this series goes on.
It's definitely one of their weak points when they're up so close to the net, and it's really allowing the Rhinos to get those counterattack opportunities. Rua in a 1v1 flick going to go just wide, and the Rhinos still looking to nab the lead here late in game one.
Yeah, we've got a minute 45 remaining. The ball is firmly in the Outlaws' half, and the challenge there from Mayhem will tee it up in the middle. Ruwaliel will get over. Evil is back and will get his second of the game. To think that this is this man's debut in MLE, you would think that he's been a seasoned veteran of many seasons with the level of confidence he's showing.
It's his MLE stream debut nonetheless. You would think a lot of players would have nerves coming into this game, but he seems so calm and collected. And so far, it's leading his team to a potential victory in game one.
Now the ball settling into the midfield. Evil will take a thunderous shot, but it will bounce off of the crossbar and out. And now Ruwaliel, with it on his hood, will go for a dribble, but Evil, with a great challenge, will take it away. Force the Rhinos back into their own half, only for a moment, as Mayhem looks to send this one forward now. Off of the corner, will not lead to anything, as Evil now looking for a dribble of his own. He'll try and get it past Ruwaliel, who will just get a touch to control it, and the Rhinos will once again survive the offensive onslaught of the Outlaws. And this has been a great showing from them in this first game. They started off a little weak on the back foot, but they found a footing, and now definitely look like the stronger team.
They definitely look like the stronger team. The Outlaws, they seem to have just lost a little confidence as they've had so many scoring opportunities and they've failed to convert them, as the Rhinos just seem to be stalwart on defense.
Now Ruwaliel sends it into the half. 30 seconds remain as Mayhem sends it towards the middle again. He'll look for a touch, but Evil will read his bluff. We'll now look to try and send it towards the net. It's just off target and Mayhem will get the clear away. And now the Rhinos on the counterattack, with only 15 seconds remaining, now are looking to get a third goal to seal this game. They aren't going to be able to do so now, and the Outlaws, maybe one final attack, sent towards the box again. Ruwaliel with another great save. Luke's not going to be able to keep this one up. It's going to fall to the ground, and the Rhinos will take game number one in this five-match series.
The Rhinos, they played a complete game, all 5 minutes. As for the Outlaws, they started off really hot, but then their offense really just kind of fizzled out. And then they were put on the back foot for this game, and it really allowed the Rhinos to put more and more pressure on. Even though they didn't have a lot of shots, the Rhino put more in than the Outlaws.
Yeah, quality over quantity in the case of the Rhinos in this game. Realizing that if they're able to soak up that pressure, they can hit them on the 1-2 counterattack. And it's worked wonderfully for them so far, especially for Ruwaliel, who has had a very strong offensive showing in this game. 2-for-2 is a very good stat. And with two saves also, he's looked really strong defensively. He's felt like there hasn't been much wrong with how the Rhinos have been playing. Maybe a little too passive at points, allowing the Outlaws to get early opportunities. But when they need to step up on offense, we know now that they can.
They can. And for the Outlaws, this game is going to just bring up more questions, where it's like they looked really strong and then they've just kind of fell off a cliff. So for game two, it's really if the Outlaws can just play a full 5 minutes.
Yeah, and if they can, and if they can keep that level of intensity that they were bringing in the early parts of game one, and bring it through here into game two, then maybe this game is theirs for the taking. They did look like the much stronger team. As we get ready to go into game number two, and the players should be joining the lobby any second now. They're all just sitting there waiting for the go-ahead. Thank you from Inanimate Jay, who's our match official for today. He's doing a great job setting all of this up for us as we get the kickoff underway, and it's going to go in favor of the Outlaws as Luke sends it deep into the runner's half. Mayhem having a bit of a moment there in the air, and this is going to lead to a shot, but a gain off target from Luke. Hasn't been able to find the back of the net since his early goal. We'll get another chance here, and Mayhem will make up for his dilly-dallying on the goal line earlier with a save.
Shaky start from the Rhinos, with the Outlaws not able to capitalize on it.
Great clear there from Luke, sending it deep into the Rhinos half. Ruelio forced to backtrack, will actually be credited with a save there, as Evil's clear was on target and going in. Now, looking to maybe go for a bump on Luke, will not find it, but Mayhem looks to apply a vice grip on offense. He'll get the ball in front of the net, but Luke will make a save this time, and the Outlaws will maintain this deadlock of 0-0 here as the first minute comes to an end. It feels like it's a lot more of a stalemate than it was at the beginning of last game.
Yep, both teams still look a little shaky on both offense and defense. So again, we're still testing the waters for both teams in this series, and we're just kind of waiting for both of them to settle in.
Mayhem there with a great touch defensively, and Luke with a little bit of a misstep there on offense will take one defender out of the play but won't get the second. Evil now with a chance, that's on target, and Mayhem is forced to make a cracking save. He's already made three in this game. That is a very strong defensive showing. Another shot comes out from Evil. This time it's off the crossbar, and he is demoed for his efforts. And now the Rhinos get to come on offense a little bit. Here comes Ruelio, controls the ball, flicks it into the midfield, but Luke will get the clear away, and the control will again switch into the favor of the Outlaws as they look to take this one from the back.
Outlaws slowing it down just a little here, and Luke can't convert just off the mark. The Rhinos seem to be so strong on defense when they're on their own goal line, but up and towards the midfield, that's when they seem to be a little shaky.
A little bit of a passing play attempt there from Evil and Luke. It didn't really come out necessarily, and it will be cleared again into the Rhinos corner. Ruelio will take it past Luke, but will not have any control over the ball. And that's something the Rhinos need to start doing a little more. They need to have control of the ball going forward. Same could be said for the Outlaws, as they will get a goal here off of a great play from Luke, a great shot from the midfield. And that all came about from a great piece of play from Evil to take Mayhem out of the game.
Yep, and Rua just not the strongest clear, puts it, keeps it in the midfield and to the waiting arms of Luke. And the Outlaws, they're in the lead once again this series, but we're gonna have to see if they can hold on to it this time.
Well, I don't think they will, as Mayhem will get a great beat there in the midfield and will get the equalizing goal here for the Rhinos. Luke had no idea what hit him with that 50.
And that was just the perfect 50 for Mayhem. Completely went the Rhinos' way. And we're back to square one.
Yeah. Feels like neither team has that much of a strong offensive hold on this game, as Evil looks to try and control this one back to the midfield. Won't get anything from it. Luke now looks to control it. You got to be feeling like these are mostly nerves coming out from the teams. I mean, you're on stream. You're the first streamed match of the day, as Mayhem immediately tries to put those nerves to bed, but it is going to backfire perhaps. The Outlaws now on a counter-attack, a 2v1 situation, but Mayhem, strong on defense once again, will keep the Outlaws at bay and almost get an opportunity for himself. Oh, almost got that one past Luke and into the net. He won't do so yet, but with a minute 30 on the clock, a chances like that, they're going to keep coming for the Rhinos if they keep this type of play up.
Yep, and for Luke, that was a great save on that last possession. You just followed through. But again, for the Outlaws, it really feels like they don't have the offensive prowess that the Rhinos have, and I'm just still not convinced.
Yeah, it feels like there is something missing from both teams, a little bit of pizzazz per se. And I feel like if there is a person to do it, it'll be either the Evilists back on the Outlaws or Mayhem on the Rhinos, the two higher salary players. There's another shot rings out from Rualiel. Could not find the back of the net yet, but now Luke, with control of the ball, looks to swing it towards the midfield. He goes in over the net, but he will not find the back of it. Evil's attempt to send it back to the middle will be cut out, and Rualiel now, with a little bit of an air dribble, will send it towards the net, and Luke will get a great save and keep out Mayhem's rebound attempt. A great little defensive stop there from Luke, showing he has all of the makings of a great backstop for this team this season.
Both these teams have been so strong on defense, and it's going to show again there. Both these teams so good with their challenges and their 50s to keep the ball away from their net. And as the clock winds down, dare I say we could go to overtime as Mayhem. Oh,
you almost jinxed it. You
just off the mark.
As it bounces down, we are into an overtime here in game number two. It is all to play for the Outlaws. They need to take this game to even up the series, but if the Rhinos take it, they will be one away from taking the series win and their first series win of this season, as Mayhem now looks to control it. Going forward, we'll get demoed for his efforts, and this is something we've seen a lot of the Outlaws do so far. Those demo plays, taking a player out of the game. It feels like they need to try and compensate for how well the Rhinos have been playing, but now an opportunity will fall to Luke. He will not miss this one. Buries it into the open net off of a great little setup from Evil and Rualiel, and the Outlaws take game number two and even this series up.
Yep, after Rua's touch there, both Rhinos players went to a corner boost and allowed Luke to get an open shot on net, and he was able to put it through as it just seemed to be routine for him. And the Outlaws, they're going to manage to get by in game two with a 2-1 scoreline, just like what we saw in game one. But plenty of more shots from both teams is something I noticed straight away.
Yeah, it feels like definitely a lot more of an offensive-based game, but you can already see how strong the teams were. Total of 9 saves in this game from both sides of the field combined. It has been a very strong performance from every single player. Hasn't felt like there has been one who has been slacking on the job. Mm-hmm. And the fact that this series is so close is such a great thing, especially considering yesterday where we had 4 straight 5-0 sweeps. We finally break the curse here today, and we get a game and a series on our hands.
And we're going to have to see how this one goes, because right now it's dead even. Both teams have won a game and lost a game by a scoreline of 2-1. So it looks like we're in for a defensive battle, as both teams seem to be very, very strong on defense.
Yeah, it feels like every goal here is the key to this game. Getting that second goal and pushing past that boundary of the defensive capabilities of the other team is really something that will decide which way the tide of this series will turn, as the players look to get ready for game number 3 here in MLE and for the Champion League. It is all to play for, and our predictions are still both technically on.
They're both technically on for now, as Luke not able to do much into the corner. Evil not the strongest shot, and Luke is put into an awkward situation on the save.
He will make the save in the process, and will look to try and clear this one away. A great challenge from Rualiel will take the ball away from him though, and the Rhinos now looking to maybe mount some offense of their own. Luke tries to take it away, but he hasn't got the greatest touch. Rualiel's touch there also off target, but Mayhem will get there and almost puts that one past Evil and into the goal, but the near post just a little bit too far, too close to him to put it away, and the Rhinos will find themselves goalless here for the opening of this game. But the Outlaws will not, as Luke scores again for the Outlaws and sends them to a 1-goal lead.
Just a great backward pass from Evil. Rua just couldn't get to the ball in time. Luke able to put it on net in the back of the net, and the Outlaws for the 3rd game in a row are going to grab the lead.
Yeah, it feels like it's the sort of preferred position is coming and starting ahead and sort of soaking up pressure. However, when the pressure is this good, as Mayhem sends another one off of the backboard of their net, it feels like now they've realized, yeah, we can't afford to sit back. Look what happened last game. They came from behind, they beat us. Now we have to push on. We have to get that second goal first and stop them from having any chance of getting that equalizing goal. As the ball goes towards midfield, Mayhem will not find it. It will instead fall to Evil, who will send a dainty little ball towards the net. But Rualiel will be there to sweep it up and maybe get a counter-attacking opportunity for himself. Launches the ball at Luke, who has enough boost to deal with it, but hasn't been able to do so. Mayhem now, with it on the hood of his car, will tee it above the net, will somehow almost get an aerial touch, but Rualiel will get the shot instead. Evil with a great clearance, and now has an open net to shoot on.
Oh, what a save!
Mayhem gets back! He got back, and he keeps it out. The Rhinos find themselves still only one goal behind for the moment, but it could still change as the Outlaws have so much offensive pressure right now. They send it off of the ceiling, looking to try and draw out a defender, but it will instead lead to them just backing off slightly, allowing the Rhinos to settle on defense, and Rualiel's clearance will clean up their lines for the moment. And what an attack that was, and what a save that was from Mayhem.
Mayhem not able to get theirs. Rua, excuse me, Luke beats Rua again. Just another great touch by Evil to extend that play.
Great speed from Luke to get up to that aerial before Rualiel, and a great goal. The Outlaws double their lead. This is the first time a team has had a two-goal lead, I believe, in this series so far. And it really couldn't have come at a better time, as Luke will be able to make it three off of that great kickoff.
And Luke again gets the better of Rua. And maybe the Outlaws are starting to take advantage of Rua, as he is a rookie coming into this season. And maybe the nerves could start beginning to get to Rua.
Yeah, the inexperienced player. He's also the lowest salary player in this lobby at a 13. So mechanically speaking, and just speaking on a term of stats alone, he isn't the strongest player, but Mayhem will find an angle and will get one back for the Rhinos, and that will shore up any confidence gaps that they had after that little bit of a miscommunication from the Outlaws.
I think that a shot from Mayhem was intended to be a pass, as he saw both Outlaw players were caught in the corner. And positioning-wise, that is an absolute never-do. And that is the reason why right there is 9 times out of 10, teams at this level will punish you for poor positioning.
Now we can see the Outlaws, they've got that vice grip on. They're throwing the ball at the Rhino's net, but they aren't going to find the back of it. As Mayhem now tees it up in front of the net, he can't put it away himself. Rualiel's shot is bumped over the bar. Mayhem now forced to take a great shot. It's a great little flick, but it's not in. Now Rualiel puts another one on target, but Luke will again clear it away. And the Outlaws' defense holds strong for the moment, as Luke is forced to make another good clear to keep the Rhinos at bay. The score remains 3-1, and it feels like this may be the scoreline we finish this game with.
It may be, but it
I
looks
just
like...
jinxed it. There we go.
And there's the jinx. As I was about to say, the scoreline may be 3-1, but it really feels like a tie game with the pressure both of these teams have put on. And the Rhinos get within one here, and a one goal in 90 seconds is definitely doable. So for the Outlaws, they can't be thinking about the next game.
Yeah, they have to be thinking about the here and now, especially when Mayhem looks to be doing double taps like that. Luke, with zero boost in his pocket, will take the back boost of the Rhinos, maybe look for a demo here onto Rualiel. He'll find it, but that will still give Mayhem the ball. He'll look for a bump, but he will not find it, and Evil will be allowed to send it deep into the Rhinos' half. The ball in an unfortunate position and a miscommunication on defense from the Rhinos will let Luke get his fourth of this game and a fourth goal for the Outlaws.
And I'm not really sure what Mayhem, like, I know what Mayhem was trying to do there, trying to get a touch to get the ball out of the harm's way, but it wasn't necessarily the right decision. I think he had better options there, and that one might have been the dagger here in game number three.
Yeah, and with so much on the line with every single game here in MLE, remember, this isn't a best of five series, it is an all five series where we play all five games. So every single game, every single goal matters. And in this case, that goal could be the clincher for this game. But Rualiel will say, not yet, Bucko. We've got a little bit of life left in us.
Evil again, not the strongest touch of Rualiel. Just going to kind of throw a lob shot up on the top shelf, and it's going to go bar down and in. And the Rhinos, again, are still not out of this game.
Yeah, especially with plays like that and the shooting like that. If they can lure out a defender and really open up that defense of the Outlaws, this really is their game to take as Luke looks to try and control it. But it is deep in the Outlaws' half, and a backflip there from Rualiel will stop the attack from really leading anywhere. Mayhem now forced to backpedal with 100 boost in his pocket. Cannot get past Evil at first. They have 10 seconds to score a goal, but they've got past one. Now looking for the beat on the second. They can't get it past Luke. The clock continues to tick down to zero, and if it hits the ground now, the Outlaws will take game three, and they will do so, taking the lead in the series for the first time this series.
And for the third game in a row, it's been a one-goal game. This time we saw a little more offense from both teams, as it felt like both teams finally just settled in and really got to play how they want to play. But again, the Outlaws, the Evil Luke combo seemed to be working really well. Luke getting all four goals and Evil getting great touches before them.
Yeah, and we're going to be going to look back at the save from the Rhinos. I believe it was Mayhem's save here. A wonderful little highlight. I just want to show you again. Has to dive back in front of it, saves it off of the crossbar, then recovers enough to then clear the ball away. A very strong play from him, and that really, it felt like that was all that they had to do, or all they were doing in this game, was sitting back on defense and cleaning up any attempts from the Outlaws. It felt like it was just Outlaw City for the majority of game three, but they did get some shots in towards the end, and that defense began to crumble of the Outlaws, and maybe this is a sign to the Rhinos, they aren't out of the series. We saw them take game one, they can still get themselves a win in this series. They will have to win the next two games here as we get ready to go back onto the field here at Utopia Coliseum. I am really interested to see how this game four goes.
Game four again, it can go either way as all the games have been one goal games. So yeah, for the Rhinos, I'd like to see the Rhinos score first and see what they can do, as the start of every game, it's been Outlaws all the way.
Yeah, now looking though to repeat history as Mayhem has to make a good save there on the goal line. Now maybe looking for an air dribble of his own. He tees it off, maybe going off the backboard, but he can't beat how Luke, who just somehow got there. Rualiel will take another shot at the net, but Luke will clear it away. Mayhem's 50 is not beneficial for the Rhinos though, and now the Outlaws looking to counterattack. Evil sends it towards the net for Rualiel's 50, will clean it away. And the Rhinos now with the ball in their half, tried to control it, weren't able to. And the Outlaws now with a bit of a mistouch there in the midfield from Evil, will allow Rualiel to shoot on an open net. No! Luke rotated back just in the nick of time. The Outlaws keep themselves from going one down here. The score remains 0-0 after 50 seconds.
I honestly didn't think Luke was going to be able to get back to that ball in time, but in the end, he did. And
great,
both these teams
there
have been just ever so close to getting that first goal.
Yeah, it feels like both of those chances there, that one on Luke and then the other one on Rualiel, they could have gone either way if that defender just had a little bit of a change in his rotation. But now, the Outlaws sending it towards the midfield. It will fall in front of the net, but Mayhem is there, and he has all of the time in the world to send that one into the Outlaws' half, but it hasn't necessarily worked out for them yet. Luke tees it off the backboard. Rualiel's not there for the touch, but Mayhem is to take it away from the shooter. Now, maybe looking for a passing play again between the Outlaws. It hasn't worked out this time, and an opportunity opens up for the Rhinos. They demo the last defender, but they can't get it on target. And Luke will be able to clean this one away for the moment. But the pressure, it has not abated yet. Now Mayhem can't get the touch he wants, and the Outlaws will finally get some control and boost in this game. And maybe they'll get a goal for themselves.
We're gonna have to wait and see in a little friendly fire. As Evil's gonna just be at the wrong place at the wrong time. He's gonna finish this one off. He's in the right place at the right time. And it looks like Luke just kind of faked out the defendant here, faked the Doomsie Dish, and just allowed Ryu to hesitate just that half a second to allow Evil to shoot the ball.
A great little play there from the Outlaws. Evil finally, I believe, getting his first goal of the series. It has been all Luke on offense to the Outlaws, but finally now deciding, I will take matters into my own hands and score one for myself. Forced to make a good save there off of Rualiel, who dived in with a challenge. Now sends it long, looking to try and get another goal for himself. It's going to bounce off the crossbar, and he will find the double. A great goal there from Evil to double the scoring for the Outlaws. 2-0.
As just both players on the Rhinos whiff for that ball right off the bounce. No one's able to follow up except for Evil. And now it looks like Evil's starting to take the majority of the workload on offense.
Yeah, and that right there seems to have just eased up how the Outlaws are playing. They are looking a lot fresher now on offense, and just in general, their rotations feel a lot slacker in a sense, where they're rotating more fluidly as Evil's going to get another touch. Meanwhile, the Rhinos feel like they're just collapsing here on defense. There is no defense to speak of as another demo comes out from Evil. It's going to be just off the target, and Mayhem will be forced to dive back and make the clearance. For now, the Rhinos, 2 goals down with 2 minutes remaining. The series is on the line. If the Outlaws take it, they will win the series, but we will play all 5 games either way. And the Rhinos will find themselves once again without a series victory in 3 weeks.
For the Rhinos,
they're
not out of it just yet. As we've seen the Rhinos play with a little more urgency. But I feel like that has cost them in a way, as they're not used to just rushing to every challenge.
Yeah, now Evil looking for another one, goes for the double, will not find it, but Luke will find the back of the net. Threads it between the two Rhinos players, and the scoreline is 3-0 for a second time this series. What a great shot from Luke.
And for the Rhinos, start of the series, they were so strong on defense, we praised them for it. And now we can see the cracks in that defensive wall, and it's starting to crumble down.
Now Mayhem looks to try and control this one and get a shot. He looks to tee it up. He will find the back of the net. Luke will not find the defensive touch, and Mayhem will add a bit of a lifeline here for the Rhinos here in game number 4. Everything to play for. He'll finally find the back of the net.
And for Luke, I think he just had a moment, as you would call it. Has a little bit of a slip up. This could allow the Rhinos to get back in it if they can get another quick one here. With a minute to go, 2 goals is possible, but the pressure's on.
Yeah, as Evil looks to try and also Luke, my apologies, tries to send this one forward. Evil looks to play blocker.
Oh my goodness.
Luke, you are a madman, but Rualiel will make the save and keep it out for the moment. The Outlaws felt a falter momentarily on offense, but I feel like that's a one-off occurrence. It's the ball teed up above the box. I thought Mayhem was going to hit that then. Would have been a great little play for the Rhinos, but they need to score now. If they're to keep themselves in this series, they need to get aggressive, and that is the price you pay when you make a mistake against the Outlaws. Evil gets his hat trick, and the Outlaws lead 4-1.
Outlaws have played phenomenally this game. As for the Rhinos, we can see now that when they're under pressure, when they have to force the issue, they can't do it. They can't live up to what's needed. And so the Outlaws, they might again take advantage of this in game number 5.
Yeah, my apologies. I am trying to pour myself a glass of my non-branded drink, as Evil will get a 4th goal to immediately hand it right back over to you. 18 seconds remaining in this game. This game's all but over.
Evil just has time and space to put this one on net. The Rhinos are just wanting to forget about this game, have it end as soon as possible, and just focus on game 5 and maybe get away with a game 5 victory to take the series 2-3, as Luke gonna get another one here, and this is just a never-ending nightmare for the Rhinos.
salt in the wounds of the rhinos. It feels like everything they're doing is just leading to more and more pain as they roll around on the beach here at the Utopia Coliseum. It feels like this is the opposite of a utopia. This is a dystopian reality for the rhinos. Without a single win in a series this season already, now find themselves with a third straight series loss. They need to try and pick it up as they look for the Brazil. Are they going to find it? I don't think they will. The ball will hit the floor at 6-1. But game three goes to the Outlaws, and a very strong performance at that.
A very strong performance from both teams. Evil had 103 bombs. I'm not too sure about that stat. But look at the 9 shots from Evil. It felt like in the earlier parts of this series, Evil was just kind of the quieter one. He was just on that back line, getting the consistent touches he needed to allow Luke to carry the workload. But in this game, Evil took it into his own hands and put 4 in the back of the net for the Outlaws.
Yeah, and normally, I've been looking back at the last game, in game number 3, it was Luke who had 4 goals and 4 shots. He was very offensively capable, and Evil had 3 assists in that game. But again, showing that he can play in pretty much every attacking aspect of the Outlaws, Evil partook in every single goal that the Outlaws scored. He either got the assists when Luke scored, or he scored them himself. He's really sort of come alive towards the back end of the series, and what a time to do so. They take the series win 3-1, but we are going to be playing game 5 to see how that game goes. In the meantime, if you're Mayhem, if you're Rualiel, what are you saying to each other in comms to try and get that momentum back? You've lost the series, but the game is still to be played. You still have the chance of going 2-3, just like you did against the Pirates. Can you pull that off, and how do you pull that off?
I think for the Rhinos.
The Scarab.
What do you know? That is the Scarab. I think for the Rhinos, you forget that you forget the last 4 games. And you play like this is a best of one. You try to play as loose and as free as you can. And to have a little fun with it, see what you can do.
Speaking of fun, that shot was almost really fun from Mayhem as he hits it from the sidewall. A good save from Evil to keep it out for the moment. Rualiel now with the King Crown on top of his Scarab. A very throwback card choice there from him. Now the ball though, centre towards midfield, but Rualiel will clear it away, and Evil will have to backtrack into his own half to try and keep him away. Mayhem tees it up off the backboard, but Luke will be there to clean it up a little bit as the Rhinos look to try and get some offensive pressure going. The Outlaws immediately break out and try to create their own.
Evil.
Now, my apologies, you carry on.
I was going to say, Evil looking to regroup. But now we see the Rhinos, they're able to keep the ball within the orange half, but they're not able to put those strong, dangerous shots on net, as there's one from Mayhem. Rua to follow up, but it's a lob, and Evil will send it high. And again, the Rhinos just cannot finish their opportunities.
Remind everyone in chat to don't forget to stay hydrated, because hydration is really the key, and that is why I was pouring my non-caffeinated beverage previously, because really, this is mouth-watering gameplay. There is so much good gameplay on my screen that I'm blessed to cast, honestly, as this ball now sits in the Rhino's half. Evil trying to send this one forward. We do want to thank one of our sponsors, Balls Garana, for sponsoring us, I believe. They are one of the nicest drinks to have. I've had a few of their drinks as Mayhem looks to send this one towards the middle. Very fun sponsor as Mayhem finds the angle. I'm gonna stop talking about balls. I'm gonna start talking about this one. What a shot from Mayhem.
Off the bump as well, not giving up on the play. The Mayhem showing he has the will to put the ball into the back of the net, and he's really doing everything he can to keep the Rhinos in this one. As Evil gonna get a freebie here to tie it up.
And it feels like this kickoff goal has just been the Outlaws' sort of namesake, in a sense. It has been their go-to move all throughout game number 4. It's how they got to that 6-1 lead, and it's how they are currently 1-1. We also want to thank our other sponsor, APM Music, for sponsoring our content. You get to hear their amazing intros that we were we were granted thanks to their sponsorship. Remember, do check them out. They are a wonderful music production site. And we do have, coming up after the series, we do have other games going on for us. Ooh. If you, oh, never mind. We'll talk about that later as Evil puts another one away. He has come alive to the back end of this series.
Evil really wants the limelight here. Be like, hey, look at me, look at me. As we really have been talking about Luke for the majority of this series, but Evil is taking his turn in the spotlight. And it is looking like the Outlaws could be leaving this matchup with a 4-1 victory.
That would be great for their season after a 5-0 win last week. I believe they are still yet to play their second game from that doubleheader. It'll be interesting to see how that fares, because so far they are looking like one of the stronger teams in Champion League this season, and they're really starting to show it here towards the back half of this series. Coming from that one game deficit at the beginning after Mayhem's great offensive performance and Rualiel's strong aerial display, as he looks now to go for an aerial in the Scarab. That would be a wonderful sight to see, but we're not going to see it yet, as Mayhem looks to tap this one down, cannot get it past Luke, and the Outlaws will hold for the moment.
The Outlaws continue the hold, and the Rhinos, they get so much offensive pressure, but as soon as that ball gets into the crease, into the box, they're just not able to do anything with it. And ooh. Caster's Curse once again.
Yeah, it feels like Caster's Curse is very prominent in this series, as that is the third time that has happened. Rualiel able to dunk Evil to put that one away. Luke completely out of position, was not expecting the shot to come out. And the Rhinos, I almost said the Pandas for some reason there, have tied this series, or tied this game back up. They wanted to take this to 2-3. They don't want to sit back and take another 1-4 loss. Now, Rualiel carrying it on his hood, drops it slightly, and Evil will be able to make the save. Now Mayhem takes it off the side wall, will flick it towards the net, it's off the crossbar and out, and the Outlaws will breathe a sigh of relief as they look to refocus on defense.
As the Outlaws continue to stay on defense, Mayhem, no way! What a dunk, absolutely posterizes Evil. Screenshot it, make it your Twitter banner. My goodness, Mayhem.
That is a Play of the Week nomination if I've ever seen one. And if you do feel like that was a Play of the Week nomination, please feel free to clip that. Send it over to our Twitter or in our Discord with the hashtag Play of the Week, or POTW for short. That right there could clinch the game for the Rhinos, and I think we'd be pretty happy with that in that case. But now, the Outlaws, a little bit scorned perhaps, maybe looking for a counter-attack of their own, but they're not going to find it immediately. Mayhem gets a demo, and then the passing play almost works out. It doesn't in fact happen, as the Outlaws will survive this attack, and they will find themselves still a goal behind. 30 seconds remaining. Can they get back on offense? Not when Mayhem is pulling out stunts like this. Where was this performance through games 2 and 4?
I think for Mayhem, he just stopped caring once this game started, and
my
he's like
Lord.
I think somehow Mayhem got an extreme confidence boost, as I'm speechless with the
physicalness. I am also speechless. Well, Evil will get one back, so the game is not over yet. We still have 16 seconds. But if the first clip wasn't a Play of the Week, that one had to have been. He just hit a flip reset, boom. I don't know, I'm not even sure if he got the flip reset, but he bumped the man in an aerial in Champion League. This is Champ 2 to Champ 3 gameplay. This is the peak of Rocket League. This man is on fire right now, and he may have just led the Rhinos into their second game in this series at the death. The ball falls down to the floor, 3 seconds remaining. Luke will try and carry it, he'll pick it up, but he won't get it into the back of the net. The Rhinos will take game number 5 and finish up this series strong. A 2-3 record for them, but the Outlaws will take this one 3-2.
And for the Rhinos, I mean, it was a really just came down to Mayhem, as he had 8 shots this game and really just kind of came into his own, as Mayhem just bodied the Outlaws, I can't find words for just how great Mayhem performing this game 5.
And to give you a little bit of just a quick replay as to what he did, we're going to show you again his second Doomsie dish. The fact that he hit 2 is insane to me. Here you can see it off of the replay. Mayhem taking it up the wall, past one defender, gets bumped, recovers, and buries it in the back of the net like it is nothing. Actually, I believe that was his first one, if I remember correctly. But still, what a player Mayhem is, and what a performance he had, especially in the back half of this series, and in game number 5 specifically. He really turned up.
He really turned up, but in the end, it just wasn't enough, as the Outlaws are going to take this series 3-2. As for Luke and Evil, they really just kind of took their turns being the star player for the duo.
Yeah, and as we look towards the next series for today, we do have, I believe, a Master League series coming your way. We have the Sharks going up against the Flames. It'll be right up next. Please, stick around. You don't want to miss this.